Okay, let's start class. So in the beginning, I think everybody should get the lecture note on your table. If you did not get one, please come here and I will give you the lecture note. So everybody got your own lecture note. Okay. In the beginning, I want to say that last 2 weeks, we already introduced something about the basic concept of the how to calculate the integration peak and their correlated intensity. And this time, before we continue to introduce the GSUS program, which is the refined program for the X-ray diffraction, I would like to let you make your own program. That means I would like to let you use the Excel program to build up overall make your own diffraction simulation pattern. Because I think if you want to become a good user of GSUS program, you need to know all the parts. I mean the how delay work or how delay calculate all the parameters in the GSUS program. So before that, I think the best way to let you know everything is write a program. But I think it's not possible for anybody because we have no idea about your program ability. So apparently, I think the Excel would be much better for everyone because at least we can install Excel in the computer because we got the authorized, right? But for our program, maybe Python, C program, I'm not sure everybody can get your own software suite. So here I will make some demonstration about how to build up a simulation X-ray diffraction pattern in the Excel file. So I write some lecture note that you can also download from iLearning. I already renew the files on website. So everyone got this one. This is some basic equation you need to know. So we will go to the part of the PowerPoint file. Okay, so let's start from this slide. Okay, last time I already write a equation about the intensity of specified HKL peak, but there is a little bit of modification because when we make a diffraction to your sample, if we utilize the X-ray as the light source, there's one more question you need to take into consideration is there is a polarizing factor here, so you will see that there's one extra term here is 1 plus a cosine squared to theta HKL. And if we take into consideration all of this term, we call that would be a Lorentz polarization factor, which are angle dependence priming. So that is a little bit modification here. That's only for the X-ray. And we also need to consider about some thermal vibration factor here. We call the bywater factor. So the structure factor will be a little bit modification. Then, for the computer calculations, it is not possible to calculate the complex because the computer doesn't recognize what is called I, right? So we need to convert the complex becomes sine and the cosine term. So we will extract here exponential 2di 2 pi hkl dot xiyzi becomes cosine 2 pi h multiply x and ky and lz. And this term will be the imaginary part, this is the real part. Okay, this is real part and this is image part. And furthermore, we need to count the intensity. So the intensity will be the proportional to the square of the structure factor. So that's the take the power of 2 of both sides. So we can get the F squared. So everything, all the equations we need to calculate in the Excel file are listed here. So we need to know the several, we need to set up several things inside the Excel. One is atomic atom position. UISO, UISO means the divided water factor. And we need to know the wavelength, scattering length. Scattering length is correlated with atomic number. Okay, that's that means the power of the the atoms to scatter X-ray to certain 2 theta. Okay. Then we also need to know the lattice constant and diffraction angle and multiplicity. So all the things that we need to know. And here I need to add one more thing. We will add one more parameter called zero here, ZERO, which means the shift of the X-ray machine. Okay, when you put the sample, it's not the certain at the center of the optical axis. I mean, you do not probably put your sample in the sample stage. That would be a little bit higher or a little bit lower. That would be case the angle shift. So we need to add one more parameter zero here. So that's all we need. And so today I want to show you all, and all of you need to upgrade the computer to make your own file. And I will make an assignment for you. And this time I want to demo the example for the this one is the gold particle, and the structure is FCC structure. And all the parameters we need is shown here are all the parameters we need. So we have the atom position, we have the scattering length here, that's correlated with the atomic number, and this is the wavelength, lattice constant, thermal vibration factor, and we also consider about the sample misalignment. So we add the zero parameter here, and we also need to know the half width. Background we, here we put the background become zero. And that's all. So please open your Excel program to your computer. And open your lecture note to this page. Okay? The difference between this one and the assignment is here we show this crystal structure is FCC. Yeah? This page. FCC, yeah, that's right. Okay? FCC, okay? And there is an extra page in the format of the Excel file already set up. So next page here is an example of the file we will fill up. You see that? Okay. So let's start it. So everyone got your computer? Do you need one? Okay, you will use one. Okay. Okay, let's start now. I will try to enlarge the cell for you. Okay, the first one we need to set up first 5 parameters is the lambda. So the first cell I will insert, I'm sorry about it. All the software right in shown here is Chinese. It's Mandarin language, but I think I will try to explain all the work for you, okay? So can you go with me and we just click this one. This means insert. We need to insert and simple. Okay, let's try to go to the form called simple. Simple, and let's find out the lambda here, because the first parameter we need to know is lambda. Do you get it? Okay, if you find it, we need to the open parenthesis, and we also need to insert another symbol called anchor. Is that okay? So the font size is not perfect. So I will go back to the I'm not sure if that change that will come. I would like to change the form size to 12. So can you do that? And I would like to select all and try to make all the characters in each cell at the center. Okay, this is a very best setup in the Excel. And then we need to add other three parameters called X constant. So we need to add A, B, and C. So their unit, the unit of latent constant are also anchor. So I will copy the parenthesis with anchor into each cell. Is that okay? Then I will add one more parameter called 0, which is the misalignment of the sample state or mislocation of sample. Okay, can you catch what? Can you catch me? Is it okay? So for the typical commercial X-ray machine, we know the wavelength is 1.5406, and for the gold material or gold metal, we know the latent constant is about 4.08 angstrom. So because they are, you know, it is the cubic metal, so I will let the C2 cell equal to B2 cell equal, I use mouse and left click this one. So this is the meaning of the C2 cell equal B2 cell. And I will drop here at the corner, so you find the mouse cursor become a plus sign, and drop the cell here. So you got all three cell from B2 to C2 are all equal to 4.08. Then the 0 here, I just temporarily put the number of 0, and we will try to change that later. Okay? So this is the first part we need to set up. Any question? Do you need some assistance? Is it okay? Okay, let's go to the second part. So, from the equations, we need to know is getting lens, but I say this lens is associated with, I mean, the proportion, the scale is proportional to atomic number. So I will type here, insert here is atomic number. And I will reduce the bone size, become 8, and become bone form. So you can check your metronome. The graph here show you there are 4 positions inside an FCC cell. So at least you need type 4 atoms here. So we know the atomic number of gold is 79. So we will type 479 in each cell. Then we need to know the relative position inside a unit cell, so we need to set up the coordinate x, y, and z. Okay? And we know FC cell, they occupy 4 positions, are 0, 0, 0, half, half, 0, half, 0, half, and the 0, half, half. Is it okay? And now let's probably is the bivalent factor. We also call thermal factor. The symbol is U iso. And I will select iso and change the format to subscript. Okay. Then the unit of UISO is n short square. So I will copy one of the n short here and put here. Then I will change the n short subscript, but at the number 2 next by n short and select 2 become superscript. So the unit will look like n short square. Is it okay? The program overall. So this is the basic parameter we need. And now let's set up the calculation part here. So the first thing we need to set up is we need to know which crystal plane will give you a strong reflection light. So you need to set up the mirror index here. So we will type here H, K, and L at each cell. And then when we return to, okay, when we go to the page 3. We will have cosine part and the sine part. The cosine part we call that's the real part. And the sine function here we call that the image part. So here we need to also set up the real part and the image part here. So I will type real part and image part. Then the next cell I will write the F square, which means the structural factor square. I will type F2 and select the 2 and change the format to superscript. This is F2. And then we need to set up the multiplicity. So I will write here capital N here. You need some assistance? You cannot find how to superscript the 2. Okay. There's superscript here. Use the latest one. Okay, then left the right rate. And here this is F, yeah, that's right. And this is the superscript. Okay? And we also need the extra parameter called Lorentz polarization vector. So I will type LP here. And we also need to know the D spacing. So we will. So in this cell, I will type D spacing. And the next one will be 2 theta. 2. And I will insert here with simple theta. And theta is in unit of degree. Okay, I'll change the form to become tail. Then the next 2 cells will be intensity. Intensity. And half width. So half width we use the symbol FWHN. FWHN in unit of degree. So I will insert symbol with degree. So first degree, okay, here. Is everything okay? Do you need some trouble? Degree. Okay. Okay, this spacing. Okay, 2 theta. And you miss the intensity. Okay, degree. Okay, intensity. Okay? So the first thing we need to calculate is we know the intensity is equal to F squared multiplied M multiplied LP. So we can just, we can first calculate the intensity here. Of course, they must be zero because we don't, the all is there are empty, so we will got to be zero value here. Is it okay? Now we need to calculate the 2 theta value. So the 2 theta value, you can go to this slide, go to the lecture note, the page. Okay, let's go to the page 3. Page 3, okay. So the blue part here, is that blue? Yeah. So in the cube itself, all the alpha, beta, gamma are 90 degrees. So these three terms become zero. We only need to input the 2 theta equal to upside lambda by 2 and root square h by a square plus k by b square plus l. Oh, sorry, this is l. Okay, this must be typo. Okay, this is l. L by c square. So we would utilize this equations in the Excel file. So the 2 theta is equal to multiply arc sine used to be simple a sine. If you don't know how to write arc sine, you can check the last page of the Excel command. Okay, a sine means the arc sine. You got it? Okay, so in this cell is 2 multiplied by a sine and the open parenthesis. The first thing is we need to know the latest step length L here, and we divide it by 2. Do you see that? So I would like to add the parenthesis here and multiply by square root. Square root use the command sqrt, and this open parenthesis. And inside here are h by a is h divided by a with parenthesis, then caret square. And we plus the